Let us consider an interesting example. Actually, I want to consider the example of substitution reaction. This is, if this were hydrogen, this becomes neopentane, neopentyl alcohol. Common system nomenclature, or as per IUPAC 1, 2, 3, 2,2-dimethyl, 1, 2, 3, 2,2-dimethyl, propane 1-ol, IUPAC name. OH group attached to primary carbon atom, but one quaternary carbon atom is present. Before considering this example, let us start with simplest example. Ethanol reacted with HBr. Of course, for HBr, for obtaining HBr to react with ethyl alcohol, we have to use NaBr and concentrated H2SO4. So, mixture of this will develop HBr and HBr will react with ethanol. But let us keep this part aside, and HBr reacts with ethyl alcohol. The product what we get is this. Let me use the color. Plus so similarly, this is a substitution reaction. OH group of alcohol gets replaced by bromine. It can be HCl, HI. I have taken example of HBr, and this is just a substitution reaction. OH group is replaced by bromine, and we get ethyl bromide. As per IUPAC, this becomes bromoethane. This is a very simple example. And similarly, if we take the example of neopentyl alcohol with HBr, what we expect is OH will get replaced by bromine, Br. The only difference is alkyl group. Alcohol, OH directly attached to aliphatic carbon replaced by Br, we expect same. But what we get is different. To understand this, what happens here, very simple to look, is expected to happen in this case also, but it does not. To understand this, we have to first try to understand the mechanism of this reaction. I have directly written the reaction, but the mechanism, the steps, the stages. Ethyl alcohol, HBr is acidic, H plus ion from this HBr. The protonation of ethyl alcohol first takes place. Now let me write it. Ethyl alcohol. Now, lone pair of electrons, there are two lone pairs on oxygen atom. Normally we don't write it. But here the lone pair of electrons, out of two, one lone pair always take part, has a role in this reaction. So, I have to write it. Will react with H plus ion from HBr. This is what we call as protonation. Let me show it here, lone pair of electrons. Although there are two lone pairs on oxygen, in future also we are going to see that only one lone pair always take part. That is only because of small size of oxygen. And protonation of alcohol, H plus ion from HBr, will develop this. Lone pair of electrons on oxygen and empty orbital of H plus ions, it becomes a shared pair. Earlier the lone pair was with oxygen, to indicate that I always use the arrow. And since the lone pair becomes a shared pair, positive charge gets transmitted to the oxygen, and this is how we can write protonated ethyl alcohol. The moment this lone pair becomes a bond pair, the next moment lone pair becomes a shared pair. So this earlier shared pair for stability undergoes heterolysis to develop a lone pair, means it will give what? This shared pair goes to oxygen producing this was hydrogen atom from HBr, H2O. So the shared pair entirely goes to oxygen, resulting in formation of a lone pair. So what remains behind is now carbonium ion. So first step is attack of H plus ion electrophile on the lone pair. We call it as protonation. The moment lone pair forms a shared pair, this earlier shared pair heterolysis of this will take place, developing a lone pair, means water is formed. And what remains behind, since the lone pair gets transmitted, is carbonium ion. Here it is ethyl carbonium ion. The moment ethyl carbonium ion is formed, it will be attacked by, now that what happens beyond that, I will show you here, I will rub this. The moment ethyl carbonium ion is formed, it is attacked by carbonium ion intermediate. At that moment it is sp2 empty orbital, it is attacked by bromide ion. Since H plus is made available by HBr, means the electron pair, shared pair, remains with bromine, resulting into Br minus ion. This bromide ion now will attack the carbonium ion and it will produce result in shared pair. At that moment lone pair of Br minus ion and empty orbital of carbon, therefore to represent that, to indicate that, I have used the arrow. Ultimately it is a shared pair, it is a covalent bond, qualitatively no difference. So although OH is replaced by halogen, here in this case it is bromine, the steps are such: first step is protonation, next step is carbonium ion formation, and after that, the moment carbonium ion is formed, it is attacked by bromide ion, resulting into bromoethane, ethyl bromide, common system. Now once we are familiar with, used to this mechanism, we will apply this mechanism to what we have decided to consider, this new pentyl alcohol. Let us see what happens. Let us continue with the example action of HBr on alcohol. Just now I have explained you the mechanism of action of HBr on ethyl alcohol. Although it is a substitution reaction, there are steps. First step is the protonation, attack of H plus ion, formation of carbonium ion, and then attack of halide as a nucleophile. So if that mechanism is in our mind, then or else like what we have considered, or ultimately what we see, OH group is replaced by halogen, one will apply same thing here, OH group will be replaced by bromine, but the things are not that way. There is certain difference. What is the difference and because of what? Let us consider. We will follow the same path mechanism. I have written HBr here. Actually, the attack of H plus ion will attack H plus ion from HBr, will attack this alcohol, lone pair of electrons on oxygen and H plus. This we call it as protonation. H plus ion is called as proton. And what we get is this. Lone pair of electrons on oxygen will get sheared between oxygen and H plus ion from HBr, and since the lone pair was under the control of command of one nucleus oxygen earlier, now it is sheared between two nuclei. The positive charge now gets transferred to this oxygen. The moment this is formed, this is not that stable. Lone pair forms a shared pair. This earlier shared pair, heterolysis of this shared pair forms, is developed, and it results in what we can write is H2O. This lone pair forms this shared pair forms a lone pair now, and therefore this will be the carbonium ion. Okay, I will write it here, carbonium ion. So these were the methyl groups earlier. Let me write the skeleton. And like what we had considered earlier, we expect that Br minus ion should attack this carbonium ion, but that does not happen. Before attack of Br minus ion on this carbonium ion, something else happens very fast. That something else is, there are three methyl groups, out of that one, let it be this. This methyl gets shifted to this carbonium ion. We call it as, now let me write in a reverse manner, 1,2 methyl shift. This methyl means the carbon and the shared pair. This methyl group with the shared pair gets shifted. It gets completely transferred to this empty orbital. And if it gets transmitted, what remains behind, let me write it here. Now this bond, the methyl group completely gets transferred. I will use a color, electron pair and methyl group with its electron pair. So the shared pair, and this methyl group, this methyl shift, it is called as methyl shift, goes to this carbon. So this will be, this one will become carbonium ion. Now how this is possible, or why this takes place? This takes place because here carbonium ion was present earlier. Bromide ion should have attacked this, like what it had done in earlier case. But the rate of that, as compared to that, this methyl shift takes place, giving rise to this carbonium ion. This is fast. This carbonium ion is tertiary carbonium ion. This was primary carbonium ion. And this, on this, the moment methyl shift takes place, we get tertiary carbonium ion, and now bromide ion will attack this carbonium ion to give So what was expected? The expected thing was OH group should get replaced by bromine. But if you follow the mechanism, the actual result is this. Expected was this OH group should get replaced by bromine, but actual result, experimental result, the proofs match with this. How this is possible? To explain the observed result, we followed the mechanism. First step protonation, then carbonium ion formation. Up till this carbonium ion formation, it is common, but primary carbonium ion, and because of methyl shift on adjacent carbon atom, in some cases it is hydrogen shift. Here on adjacent carbon atom, methyl group, only methyl groups are present, three methyl groups. Out of that one, it gets shifted toward to this carbonium ion. This shift is possible, it is possible only in those cases where, of course, methyl group should be present on adjacent carbon atom, where primary carbonium ion after methyl shift gets converted into tertiary carbonium ion. And why this happens? The reason lies in stability of carbonium ion, as we have studied earlier. On the basis of hyperconjugation, we have studied that tertiary carbonium ion is more stable than secondary, than primary. This is primary carbonium ion. Carbon atom is attached to only one other carbon atom. This one is tertiary carbonium ion. Carbon is directly attached to three other carbon atoms. This is more stable, as we have studied. The explanation for this we have considered on the basis of hyperconjugation. The intermediate is more stable, and now bromide will attack and give rise to this product. So whatever normally we expect, entirely different thing has happened. The explanation for that is possible only if we know the mechanism, that is one thing, and secondly, hyperconjugation, knowledge of hyperconjugation effect, the importance of that is known to us, or it is only possible for us if we know hyperconjugation effect to explain this, what we have actually observed and what we had expected.